The glute is another spot where we're going to find a lot of muscle damage, a lot of scar tissue and adhesions. It comes from squatting. It comes from these functional movements we execute. To work her glute, Eva Claire is just going to roll onto, off that IT band, onto her butt, more or less. Now, she's on her glute medius, which is the side of the hip as we're moving towards the butt. She's got, on the side she's trying to work, she's got that leg crossed over, her ankle on her other leg, and her knee up. And that's going to allow her to modify how much pressure she puts on the glute by rolling back and forth laterally. Again, there's nothing magic going on here. We're looking for painful spots. We're hanging out on them until they stop being so painful, and we're moving on. Of course, we're not just going to do this to one leg. We're going to do it to both. But if you find that you're having knee problems, that you're having issues, whether it's on the front of the knee, the sides, the inside, that this is going to be a process that's going to make you feel a lot better very quickly. Once we've worked the glute, we're going to move to the adductor, to the inside of the leg, to the VMO. This is where I get a ton of pain, right down near the knee. And if you're a depth squatter, okay, if we're getting below parallel, as all CrossFitters should be, if you're an Olympic lifter, if you're dragging your butt on the ground constantly in the bottom of those snatches and the bottom of those cleans, you're going to find that this part of your body is going to develop some pretty big knots. And you're going to be pretty surprised when you get in there the first time and find out just how painful that is. But again, important process. EC gets in an army crawl. She basically puts the inside of her leg up on that roller. She's gonna roll from the knee to the hip, just like we have in every other process we've got here, looking for knots.
Ding, ding, ding.
Ding, 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 we have a winner, ladies and gentlemen. You can see a seasoned athlete like Eva Claire has them all over the place in the legs. And if she's got pain in her joints, especially that knee, resolving these is going to go a long way towards making that feel better. In the absence of a diagnosis of some sort of degenerative disease, this should be your first place. Don't go with the idea that you have bad knees. Don't live with that. Don't go with the idea that you can't run, you can't deadlift, you can't squat. We're going to take the time, we're going to foam roll, and we're going to find those places of scar tissue, we're going to find those adhesions, get rid of them. This foam roller can be applied in virtually any way. As long as you're making good contact with the muscle in question, as long as you're up around or near that joint that hurts, you're probably doing yourself some good, and it's very difficult to do harm with this. Now, there are some places you can go after you've foam rolled. My first recommendation, get yourself a clinical masseuse, an active release technique therapist. Get yourself someone who's worked with athletes. We're not talking hot rocks and scented candles and a spa atmosphere. Soft tissue work hurts. To be effective, it does not feel good. But as a CrossFitter, as an athlete, if you're not doing this, you're not going to hit your potential. So go get that foam roller.